Today I will discuss about the mechanism of photosynthesis. Mechanism of photosynthesis I explain as the two type of reactions, light reaction which occurs in the daytime and dark reaction which occur in the night. But light reaction occur in the grana part. Light reaction occur in the grana part of the chloroplast, where the water is utilized in the presence of photon or light. Photolysis of water take place, then water breaks into the hydrogen ion, electron, and removal of oxygen gas take place. This oxygen gas now comes out from the chloroplast in the cytoplast part. This is cytoplasm of the cell. So oxygen reaches in the cytoplasm of cell from the chloroplast grana. As the photophosphorylation, which also occur in the presence of light, in the presence of photon, when the adenosine diphosphate combined with inorganic phosphate in the synthesis of adenosine triphosphate. Adenosine triphosphate has assimilatory power synthesized in the light reaction of photosynthesis which occur in the grana. During the light reaction, by the help of NADP positive and the hydrogen ion, which generally produces during the photolysis, and electron also reaches, which generally present in the photolysis. So this hydrogen ion, electron combined with the NADP. So this electron hydrogen ion when combined, then the NADP changes into NADPH plus H positive, which act as reducing power in the chloroplast. ATP and NADPH plus H positive both are utilized in the dark reaction which occur in the stroma, in which reduction of carbon dioxide take place, which has taken from the atmosphere. When carbon dioxide enters by the help of different types of enzyme, as the enzyme is Rubisco, RUBISCO. In the presence of Rubisco enzyme, the compound RUDP, ribulose 1,5 diphosphate, changes into the 3 carbon compound phosphoglyceric acid, 12 molecule, and this phosphoglyceric acid synthesized by the help of use of ATP एंड NADPH plus H2O2 synthesis of carbohydrate in the form of glucose take place. Glucose is good example of carbohydrate. So, in the direct reaction of photosynthesis, reduction of carbon dioxide take place. But in the light reaction which occur in the grana, several steps occur. As first step is activation of chlorophyll. Normal chlorophyll activate by the help of sunlight. Here, normal chlorophyll when activate, then this chlorophyll presents the photolysis of water take place. Photolysis of water occur in the photosystem second of light reaction, where water molecule breaks into the hydrogen ion, electron, and removal of oxygen gas. This oxygen gas comes out from the chloroplast in the cytoplasm of the cell. During this, photophosphorylation also occurs, in which adenosine diphosphate combined with inorganic phosphate in the presence of photon and formation of ATP. Adenosine triphosphate take place. ATP is considered as assimilatory power in the chloroplast. As the synthesis of NADPH plus H positive also take place in the light reaction. As the electron transport from the photosystem second to photosystem first reaches to the pyridoxine, where NADP positive combined with the hydrogen ion produces during the photolysis of water, then synthesis of NADPH plus H positive take place, which utilize in the dark reaction in the stroma, where in the dark reaction the RUBP H5 carbon compound ribulose 1,5 diphosphate in the presence of enzyme rubisco ribulose 1,5 bisphosphate carboxylase in the presence of carbon dioxide and in the presence of ATP. Here the PGA H3 carbon compound produces this first stable product. 3 carbon compound produces, that is why it is called C3 cycle or Kelvin-Benson cycle on the honor of the discoverer of this cycle. So ATP is called as assimilatory power and NADPH plus H positive called as reducing power in the sketch. This is the overall a type of relationship, a type of interaction between light reaction and dark reaction. I have noticed that the product of light reaction like ATP and NADPH plus H positive are used up in the dark reaction in the night in the stroma part, and few enzymes used up in the reduction of carbon dioxide into the carbohydrate as glucose molecule synthesized, which has molecular formula C6H12O6. After the discussion of the schemes as for mechanism of photosynthesis, I want to discuss about the few steps which involve in the explanation of the light reaction clearly. Few discovery. As first of all, I told you about the immersion effect. What is immersion effect? This is the important question in the several examination. In the board examination, the question also may ask what is means of red drop, as in several competitive examination the question has asked what is red drop. So immersion in 1958 saw that when the wavelength of red light, wavelength of red light is more than 680 nanometer, falls on the chlorophyll, then minimize photosynthetic yield. Here, due to the minimization of photosynthetic yield, when the wavelength of red light more than 680 nanometer falls on the chlorophyll, this is called as immersion effect, or this is also noticed as red drop. It is also called as red drop because the wavelength range as 680 nanometer in the range of red light. So in the range of red light, the wavelength which minimize photosynthesis, that is why the term applies as red drop. For this, the scientist name, according to the scientist name, it is called as immersion effect. It is called as immersion effect. So immersion effect is known as red drop, as minimized photosynthesis when the wavelength more than 680 utilized. As I discussed in previous lecture, as more wavelength, then the pigment color has less energy. So in the less energy, photosynthetic yield minimized. This is called as immersion effect or red drop. Now one important point is that is immersion enhancement effect. What is means of immersion enhancement effect? This is another topic. इमर्शन एंड कोवर्कर, इमर्शन एंड हिज कोवर्कर्स सा दैट व्हेन मोर देन 680 नैनोमीटर एंड लेस देन 680 नैनोमीटर वेवलेंथ ऑफ लाइट दैट इज द मोनोक्रोमेटिक लाइट फॉल्स ऑन द क्लोरोफिल देन फोटोसिंथेटिक यील्ड इंक्रीजेस, फोटोसिंथेटिक यील्ड इंक्रीजेस, दिस इज कॉल्ड इमर्शन इनहेंसमेंट इफेक्ट, इमर्शन इनहेंसमेंट इफेक्ट शोज दैट देयर आर प्रेजेंस ऑफ टू टाइप ऑफ सिस्टम इन द फोटोसिंथेसिस इन द लाइट रिएक्शन एज इन द लाइट रिएक्शन देयर आर टू टाइप ऑफ फोटो सिस्टम डिस्कवर वन इज फोटो सिस्टम फर्स्ट एंडर इज फोटो सिस्टम सेकंड एज इन केस ऑफ फोटो सिस्टम फर्स्ट द रिएक्शन सेंटर इज पी 700 एंड इन केस ऑफ फोटो सिस्टम सेकेंड रिएक्शन सेंटर इज पी 680 सो डिफरेंसेस फाउंड इन द रिएक्शन सेंटर इन केस ऑफ फोटो सिस्टम सेकेंड विच इज P680 and in case of photo system first it is P700 as reaction center. What is reaction center? This is the question. So I explained about the reaction center and the accessory filament. Here suppose this is for filament system first. As reaction center I have discussed already is P700. P700 is reaction center of PS first, means फोटो सिस्टम फर्स्ट एज रिएक्शन सेंटर सराउंडेड बाई द मेनी एसेसरी पिगमेंट लाइक दिस रिएक्शन सेंटर ऑफ क्लोरोफिल ए सराउंडेड बाई द एसेसरी पिगमेंट लाइक कैरोटिनाइड When the photon falls on the accessory pigment, these are photons. I have discussed about the photons in previous lecture. Photons are the unit of sunlight reaches on the leaf in the form of energy packets. When these photons reaches on the accessory pigments are in the form of carotenoids. Here the chlorophyll CHL 600 provide energy to the chlorophyll 700. Here you can say chlorophyll 660, then chlorophyll 670, then chlorophyll 680, then chlorophyll 690, then chlorophyll 700. Now the energy reaches to the reaction center P700. Then this reaction center as chlorophyll, the excitement result 2 electron emitted by this, and these 2 electron now received by the electron acceptor as iron sulfur protein act as the first electron acceptor or first electron receptor compound. Here in case of PS first, which is called as the cyclic photophosphorylation. It is called as cyclic photophosphorylation. Why it is called cyclic photophosphorylation? This is the question. Because the electron emitted during the excitement of reaction center of pigment system first reaches to the reaction center by passing to different electron acceptor, like AFIS passes this electron to the hydroxyl, and hydroxyl passes this electron to the cytochrome B6 passes this electron to the cytochrome F, and cytochrome F passes this 2 electron to the plastocyanin. From plastocyanin, electron reaches to the reaction center. Here between the cytochrome B6 and cytochrome F, the photophosphorylation occur, in which the ADP combined with inorganic phosphate and produces ATP. So this ATP production occur in the presence of photon. That is why it is called as photophosphorylation. But the transfer of electron occur in the cyclic way, as electron during the excitement of the reaction center P700, first electron acceptor or first electron receptor, which is iron sulfur protein, passes the electron to another electron receptor like FD. FD means ferredoxin. Ferredoxins transfer this electron to the cytochrome B6, and cytochrome B6 when transfer the electron
to the cytochrome F, then sufficient energy found which combine the adenosine diphosphate with inorganic phosphate in the synthesis of ATP. Now electron from cytochrome F transferred to plastocyanin, then electron reaches to the P700. Here, in case of pigment system first, it is found that cyclic photophosphorylation take place, and pigment system first, which generally has the P700 as the term applied, which generally has the photons as having the more wavelength photons accepted by the reaction center of photosystem first, which abbreviation is PS first, and there is production of adenosine triphosphate take place during the transfer of electron between the cytochrome B6 and cytochrome F. Then this pigment system first is known as cyclic photophosphorylation is found in PS first. But what is means of non-cyclic photophosphorylation? This is the question. So in the case of non-cyclic photophosphorylation, which generally found in the case of pigment system second, as the pigment system second, which generally has the reaction center as P680. In case of PS second, reaction center is P680, which surrounded by the accessory pigment. As accessory pigments provide the energy to the reaction center as photons reaches on the accessory pigment. Then in the case of PS second, the chlorophyll as 650 reaches to the chlorophyll 660, then 670, then chlorophyll 680, it reaches to the P680. P680, the energy as the emission of electron after excitation, now received by the FeO as first electron acceptor. Now FeO provide energy as in the form of electron to the PQ. PQ provide cytochrome B6. Cytochrome B6 provide cytochrome F, and then cytochrome F provide to the PC. These two electron continue reaches from one acceptor to another acceptor. But in case of PS second, here the formation of ATP occur between the cytochrome B6 and cytochrome F. In the case of the pigment system second, photolysis also occur. Here the photon reaches on the water as H2O which has broken into the 2H positive plus 2E negative plus half O2 in the presence of photon, in the presence of manganese and chloride ion. So this electron used up in the as oxidized P680. Now the P680 which emit electron which reaches to the P700 and then reaches to the AFIS, where it generally taken by the feridoxin, and the feridoxin is the NADP. Now accept the this hydrogen of the PS2 hydrogen ion, and here the two electrons which generally combine to the NADP positive. Now the formation of NADPH plus H positive take place, which is used in the dark reaction of photosynthesis. In this way, you saw that NADPH H positive synthesized in the photosystem second, and this photosystem second and photosystem first which look like the Z-shaped structure. So this is also called as Z scheme of photosynthesis. This is also called as Z scheme of photosynthesis or Z scheme of light reaction. Z scheme of light reaction of photosynthesis, which generally look like the Z alphabet of the such sequence as photosystem second, electron doesn't reaches again to the reaction center. That is why it is called as non-cyclic photophosphorylation. It is called as non-cyclic photophosphorylation for the PS second. So PS first is called cyclic photophosphorylation, although PS second is called non-cyclic photophosphorylation, and these both are shows the light reaction of photosynthesis, or you can say jet scheme. The photosystem seconds which has the less wavelength photons absorptions in the range of 680 nanometer wavelength, and the reaction centers PS first, that is P700 of PS first, absorb much wavelength of photons as about the 700 nanometer. So in this way, study about the mechanism of photosynthesis in very brief, and the importance of the different types of pigments also notice here, as in the form of accessory pigment which provide energy to the main pigment chlorophyll, in the form of reaction center in the photosystem first, in the case of photosystem second, generally accessory pigments are present in the form of carotenes and phycobiloids or phycobilins. But in case of photosystem first, the reaction centers P700 and accessory pigments are many, like chlorophyll 660, chlorophyll 670, chlorophyll 680, chlorophyll 690 and chlorophyll 700, which ultimately provide energy to the PU700. But in case of photosystem second, the accessory pigments are chlorophyll 650, chlorophyll 660, chlorophyll 670, chlorophyll 680, and which provide the energy to the P680.